Hello everyone, welcome to Zero Labs. Today is Saturday, July 4th, 2015. I'm Mark Brash, your host, and today I officially throw my hat into the Keshe Foundation plasma reactor ring. So, Mr. Keshe has been making an awful lot of noise lately, and I'm on his mailing list, and I've been sitting by casually on the sidelines, mocking and observing, and for the most part, just yawning, you know. The claims are really wild. He claims to be releasing his technologies to the world, and the reactor designs appear to have been simplified down to the point where the average experimenter can replicate them. So, okay. All right. I give up. I'm in. All right. As with my HHO experiments, when I attempted to perform the runtime experiments, I went into those experiments, as all of you know, with the full expectation of complete failure, and allow the data to speak for themselves. That way, you know that I was not biased towards success. I was biased more towards failure, and if the data proved otherwise, it would be something believable. So too will it be with my approach to the Keshe Plasma Reactor Energy Harvesting System. Okay. I will, as with the HHO experiments, attempt a worthwhile and faithful replication of what Keshe has presented over the last couple of days, July 2nd and July 3rd, in his live broadcast that he just recently published. I'll post links down to it below. I have become active at the Keshe Foundation Forum, asking questions to help fill in the blanks so that I can get up to speed as quickly as possible with the technology. I use that term very loosely. However, I will attempt a faithful replication of what has been shown. To that end, I have already gone out and purchased sodium hydroxide as a caustic, 6 ping pong balls for my reactor. Probably mistakenly, I purchased some Walmart brand Great Value salt, which is primarily salt with calcium silicate. I'm not sure if that will adversely affect the experiment or not. The true recipe calls for sea salt, and I have ordered a 5-pound bag of sea salt. It should be here in the middle of next week. Did I mention that I bought a 50-foot roll of zinc? No, I don't think I mentioned that yet. This is a 50-foot roll of zinc that's actually intended to be used as a moss preventer that is inserted underneath the cap at the peak of a roof line to slowly disperse the zinc across your roof and eliminate moss. According to the label, it's a federal offense to use this in any way other recommended. So apparently, I'm going to go to jail for using it to make carbon dioxide or carbon dioxide nanostate, or GANS as Keshe calls it. I have some flat iron bar to use in the solution process for making CH3. I've got a couple of plastic tubs. I have some 1.5-inch wide copper strapping that's used for RF grounding, but in this case it will be repurposed. Hopefully I don't go to jail for that either. This is the material that you use as the nano-coated electrode in your baths. And I have some, actually I have about a gallon and a half of distilled water right now. I'll probably end up needing more later on. On order is 6 ounces of titanium dioxide fine powder and a, like I said earlier, a 5-pound bag of sea salt to replace this. They should be here next week. So, my intent for doing this experiment. I have long promised myself I would not even bother, but what the hell? Okay? Let's put this to bed once and for all. What I believe the most likely outcome will be is that I follow the recipe exactly, and I will invite anyone to critique my methodology to make sure that I have precisely followed the recipe. And once I have done so and seen that it does not work, discredit Mr. Keshe so profoundly that I drive him into hiding and we never see or hear from him again, or on the infinitely minuscule chance that it actually does work, well, then that changes everything then, doesn't it? And I will be pleasantly surprised like I was with the HHO experiments. So that's it. I'm in. All right, game on. Let's see what happens. Thank you all for watching. I hope you enjoy this series. It should take a couple of weeks to complete. We'll see what happens. I'm still looking for some DC motors. But anyway, as always, please rate, share, comment, subscribe to my videos, and enjoy my videos. And peace, everyone. Alrighty then, looks like my first attempt at CO2 GANS was a complete bust. As soon as I attached the electrodes together, the nano coating that was on the copper electrode immediately just fell away and fell to the bottom of the canister. So either the calcium silicate in the salt that I purchased, not sea salt but table salt, affected the process, or the copper annealing method of nano coating the copper was not effective enough to withstand the brutality of the process of electrolysis. So, looks like I have to go the slow boat to China and use the caustic method of nano coating the copper plates.